Hi everyone, welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how to find maximum and minimum elements in an array. So let's go to Eclipse and I'll just create a new class. I'll say max and minimum elements in array. Let's take main method and then finish. So here I will define one array which contains some number of elements. Let's say integer a equal to, right? So here I'll define some number. There's a 50, 30, 40, 20, and 10. So these are the elements, 50, 30, 40, 20, and 10. Or we can also have, it's make it as a 60, okay? So these are the current values in an array. So this is an array variable. Now, how to find the maximum value in this array? So first we need to consider the initial value or initial element in this array is a maximum element. Let me define a variable called max. And I'll assume a of 0th element. That means the first element, 0 representing the index 0. So the first element I'll consider as a maximum element. Now what I have to do is, I need to compare this every element with this maximum. If element is greater than this maximum, then make that element as a maximum. So we need to replace that. So once again, I'm repeating. We need to compare each and every element with this maximum value. If it could find any element is greater than this maximum, then we have to make that value as a maximum. So for that, I'll write one loop statement. And here, 0th element I already consider as a maximum. So I'll start from 1. And how many times you need to repeat till the last value? So I'll say I less than a dot length. And then I'll increment value of I. So here what I have to do is we need to capture each and every value. Compare with this maximum. If this value from the element, the value from the array which is greater than this maximum value, then we have to replace. So here I will write one condition. If from array I'm capturing the first element which is greater than maximum value, whatever currently I'm assuming max is a of 0, if this value is greater than this maximum, then we have to replace this maximum is 30. So that we need to say. Now the maximum value I am replacing with a of I. So this thing should happen only if the array element is greater than this maximum. Okay. Now the semicolon. So the first round what happened is, so here maximum is 0. So here initially the maximum value is 50. Right. So 50 a of 0 means 50. Now here I'm starting from the 1. So 1 means it will start from the 30, 30 to 60. So let's see the condition now. So a of I, what is the a of I here? A of 1, a of 1 means 30. So 30 greater than, what's the maximum number I'm currently having? 50. So 50, so 30 greater than 50. So the condition is false. So now what I have to do is, we need to have the 50 as a maximum number. So 30 is not greater than 50. So 50 should be maximum. So let's say 50 in the maximum variable. So a of I is 50, 50 will be storing as maximum. So now the current value of the maximum is 50. So current value of the maximum is 50 because the condition is false. So we have replaced. So the next round, again, it will go up and now get the next value, which is 40. So now I value is 40. So I value is 2, which is 40 now. So which is 40. Now again, check the condition. So which is 40, a of I means 40 now. So a of I is 40, which is greater than maximum. So 40 greater than, what's the current value of maximum? 50. So 40 greater than 50. So condition is false. So this condition is false. So we don't need to replace this value. So again, it will go up. So now we capture 20. There's a next value. Now a of I, which is 20 greater than maximum. So currently maximum is 50. So value is 20. So 20 greater than 50. So 20 greater than 50. Condition is true or false? Condition is false. 20 is not greater than 50. So again, this loop will not execute. This condition will not satisfy. Again, if it go up, next it will capture the 60 now. 60. Now the current value we are captured from array is 60. Now a of I 60. So 60 greater than current value of maximum is still 50. So 60 greater than 50. Now this condition is true. Then it will come here. Then it will replace the value. So now maximum value becomes 60. A of I value 60, 60 will be stored in the maximum. Now the maximum value will become 60. Now again, it will go up and now The 60 is the last number, so there are no more values. So condition become false. It will come out from the for loop. So once you come out from the for loop, this maximum variable is having the maximum value. Now here I'm printing system.out.println. Say maximum element in array is, I'm printing a maximum here. So this is how we need to find the maximum number, right? So let's execute this code and see. Right click, run as Java application. Yeah, now it is saying maximum element is 60. Suppose I'll make this 30 as an 100. Now we can see which one is the maximum number. Run as Java application. So the maximum element is 100. So this is how we need to find the maximum value from this array. Okay, in the same way, we can also find minimum value from this array. Okay, now I'll show you how to find minimum value from array. So let me just comment this array. Comment this code till here. So again, I'm just using the same array. So initially I need to consider the first value is minimum. So integer, let's say minimum is equal to a of 0. So the first value in the array I'm considering as a minimum value. Now what we have to do is, it is just like finding maximum value. Here also we need to find the minimum value. So here we need to take each and every element from this array, check whether this is less than this minimum element or not. If this element is less than this minimum, and then replace this element with minimum. So have this value inside this minimum. So let me just write one loop, let's say for, and zero value I'm already considering. So here I'll start from integer I equal to 1, I less than or equal to a dot length, how many times you need to repeat, decided by the length, and then I plus plus. So here we need to capture this element. Let me also put array here. So first value I'm considering as a minimum. So now we need to capture each and every value, next value from array, compare that value with this minimum. If you found these values are lesser than this one minimum, then we have to make those value as a minimum. So here I'll say, from array, I'm capturing the I value, which is less than our minimum. Okay, I put one conditional statement here. Let's say if a of I less than minimum, then what I should do, suppose minimum is having a of 0, which is 50 now. So I'm getting the value from array, which is the next element 100, which is less than the existing minimum. So for example, here minimum value I'm considering as a 50, right? So here the minimum is a of I is 50, a of I is 100 here, because 50 already is 0. We have already considered this as a minimum element. So here I is equal to 1. So a of 1 means 100 less than, what is the minimum value we are considering? A of 0, that is 50. So 100 less than 50. 100 is less than 50? No, which is not true, right? So if it is not true, we should not interchange the values. Still minimum value is equal to 50. But if it is not true, we need to replace those values. So then we need to make a minimum is equal to a of I. If the condition is true, then we need to make it, or else go to the next line, and then here I value becomes 2 now. So a of 2 means it will get the 40. Now the 40 less than 50. So 50 still minimum value. So 40 less than 50 is true or false. Now it is true. So as soon as the 40 less than 50 is true, now we need to make 40 as a minimum. So a of I contains a 40, I'm making 40, I'm storing 40 inside the minimum. So now the current value is minimum is become 40, right? So now again go up. Next I value is 3. Now it will capture the 20 is the next element. Now a of I is 20, a of I is 20. Now minimum value is become 40 earlier, right? So now the current value of minimum is 40. So 20 less than 40, 20 is less than 40. So condition is true. So if it is a condition is true, 20 less than 40, condition is true. If it is a true, then it will go and interchange the values. Now the minimum value should become 20. So 20 we need to assign to the minimum. So now minimum value becomes 20. Now again it will go up, get the next value, which is 4, that is 60. Now the 60 less than minimum, let's see. Now 60 is a value we are getting from array. Less than, what is the current value of minimum? 20. Now 60 less than 20, so the condition is false, so we should not interchange. So minimum still 20. Now again it will go up. Now I value become 5. So as soon as I value become 5, the condition become false. Now it will come out from this loop. By the time this minimum variable contains a minimum value. Now here I'm printing a minimum value. Let's say minimum element in array is, I will just print the value of minimum. That's it. Right. So now let us test this. So currently these are the values I have. Let's run as a Java program. And okay, so something is missing here. Let's cross check. So here we are starting from 1. So we need to go till end of the value. So I'll make this I less than a dot length. Okay. Let's execute now. Run as Java application. So now we got minimum element is 20. Right, so minimum element is 20 is a minimum. So for example, I make it as a 10 now. So now the minimum element should be 10. So let's execute. Now the minimum element is 10. Okay, so this is how we need to write logic to find the largest or a maximum and a minimum element from array. Okay, so that's all for this video, guys. So thanks for watching.